O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the roar, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then is my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art.
Everybody, serve the Lord in all your ways and come before Him, praise and singing, enter now His courts with grace. For the Lord our God is gracious, and His mercy is everlasting. Jubilate, Jubilate te you. Jubilate, everybody, serve the Lord in all your ways and come before His presence singing, enter now His courts with praise.
Good evening, friends.
Good evening, Father.
And welcome. Welcome to this evening celebration, and I thank God that we have joined you in your families, and we pray God that you may bless all of you, every member in your family, no matter where they are right now, but we pray to the Lord to grant you all good health of both body and mind, success in your work, and also pray that you may find time during the day to spend time with the Lord, because we require the Lord at all moments of our life. Thus, in praying for you all, we have the Holy Mass offered in thanksgiving to St. Anthony by Amy Randive and the members of her family, and thanksgiving Mass in honor of Mother Mary, offered by Mrs. Josephine Thomas, and Edward Francis. And we join with the Sebastians, Victor, Vincent, Devonason, Matthews, Alvarez, Ashwin, Jyoti, and Deepu, and all the other members of the family. Not forgetting our team, Lionel, Edward, Jessica, Simon, Jennifer, Surya Narayan, and Selvaraj, and ask the Lord to accept all the prayers that we want to offer to the Lord. We now begin with our Eucharist. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Yes, my dear brothers and sisters. We have got two beautiful readings today. Jesus had offered one single sacrifice. And after that he ascended to his Father and is seated at the right hand of his, not taking rest, but working with the Father and intercede for us. We priests, we offer this Eucharist every day in our lives, offering it for the sinners of the world and ourselves too. But Jesus, only one sacrifice, and that was enough for the whole world, strengthening our people that they may leave the sinfulness behind. You are called, my friend, to become holy and perfect. And that Jesus is today going to once again speak to us the parable of the sower. This parable we have heard so many times in our lives. We have even acted this out in small plays in our Sunday school at Mass. Now think of the sower coming to your heart, making your heart free from all worries and difficulties that trouble you. Because he says, I am preparing to sow the seed of love, peace, joy and happiness, and the seed that you may grow in forgiving the other. Thus today, as we partake of this sacrifice, let us spend a little moment asking pardon from him for all our faults and our failures, that he may make us worthy to partake in this sacrifice and to become ever holy and perfect.
Dayā karuṇīṣṭa mā
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of the Hebrews. All the priests stand at their duties every day, offering over and over again the same sacrifices, which are quite incapable of taking sins away. Jesus, on the other hand, has offered one single sacrifice for sins, and then taken his place forever at the right hand of God, where he is now waiting until his enemies are made into a footstool for him. By virtue of that one single offering, he has achieved the eternal perfection of all whom he is sanctifying. The Holy Spirit assures of this. He says, "First, this is the covenant I will make with them when those days arrive." And the Lord then goes on to say, "I will put my laws into their hearts and write them on their minds. I will never call their sins to mind or their offenses. When all sins have been forgiven, there can be no more sins offerings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your response be, "You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old."
You are a priest forever,
a priest like Melchizedek of old. The Lord's revelation to my master: "Sit on my right. I will put your foes beneath your feet." Your response:
"You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old."
The Lord will send from Zion your scepter of power. Rule in the midst of all your foes. Your response:
"You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old."
Acclamation.
Hallelujah. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. You have the message of eternal life.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
Okay, Father.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to teach in the lakeside, but such a huge crowd gathered round him that he got into the boat on the lake and sat there. The people were all along the shore at the water's edge. He taught them many things in parables, and in the course of his teaching, he said to them, "Listen. Imagine a sower going out to sow. Now it happened that as he sowed, some of the seed fell on the edge of the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some seeds fell on rocky ground, where it found no soil, and sprang up straight away. Because there was no depth of earth, and when the sun came up, it was scorched up. Not having any root, it withered away. Some seeds held into thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it produced no crop. Some seed fell into rich soil, and growing tall and strong, produced crops, yielded 30, 60, even 100-fold. And it said, "Listen, anyone who has ears to hear." When he was alone, the disciples, together with the others who formed his company, asked what the parable meant. He told them, "The secret of the kingdom is given to you, but to those who are outside, everything comes in parables, so that they may see and see again, but not perceive. May hear and hear again, but not understand. Otherwise, they might have converted and be forgiven." And he said to them, "Do you not understand this parable? How then will you understand any other parables? What the sower is sowing is the word. Those on the edge of the path where the word was sown are people who have no sooner heard it. The Satan comes and carries away the word that was sown in them. Similarly, those who receive the seed on patches of rock are people who, when they first hear the word, welcome it at once with joy. But as soon as no proof to them, they do not last. Should some trial come or some persecution on account of the word, they fall away at once. Then there are others who receive the seed in thorns. They have heard the word, but the worries of this world, the lure of riches, and all the other passions come in to choke the word, and so it produces nothing. And there are those who have received the seed in rich soil. They hear the word and accept it and heal the harvest, 30, 60, and 100-fold. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins.
Amen.
I obey. Oh,
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. Accept our offering, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Today we surrender ourselves to you with our families. Accept us and bless us, and may the seed of your love grow within us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the guests we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let them do all, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
The Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Bring them and all the departed into the light of the faith. Have mercy on all of us who have gathered here this evening. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, a Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints who are pleased throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The Savior's command and from God you went teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above everything.
and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, as though you were already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Allow me not to be separated from you. Jesus, my good, my sweet and only love, inflame this heart of mine, that it may be always on fire for you.
Prayer for the year of Saint Joseph. Together, hail guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
Communion and defend. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift. Bless us as we return, asking and pleading for your mercy. Grant us grace to go about doing good. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you all and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
So dear friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joining with your family at this celebration. Intercede for each other every day. Pray for all those who are asking you to pray. I hope people are asking you to pray. They will ask you if they see you that you are holy and perfect, that you are going about doing good. And if they see you, surely they will come and request you to pray. So become holy and perfect. And don't forget, this Sunday, Archbishop Thomas Dapodi will be here to confer the sacrament of confirmation. We have the usual Mass at 7 and 8:15, but a special Mass for the confirmation children, their parents, and only their invitees with the teachers. Others pray for our children that receiving the Spirit, they may be set free to proclaim the good news. So thank you and take care. God bless you and our team.